We have today is a Audi TT Sport Club Malaysia. So today they invite us for their annual event, which is our honor to come to this event. And the best is we can see a lot Audi TT behind us, as you can see, right? So guys, there is about 70, I heard. I'm not very sure.
Yes, I'm Alex from TTSCM. I'm one of the committees.
Okay.
So let's go and have a look at the cars.
Alright, let's go.
Okay. Okay, this event is one of the biggest annual gathering. Okay, this is the fourth annual gathering lah. Okay, we have 70s Audi TT. This is the very first generation of the Audi TT. Okay. It's called the TT MK1. Okay, we have two types lah. One are the manual transmission. Mm-hmm. One is the DSG models.
So in Malaysia for the first generation,
yes,
is it a lot many in Malaysia?
It's very rare.
Very rare.
Very
so
rare.
This must be very expensive.
No. No, yes.
How come rare is not expensive? This is a question, right?
Yes. Okay. Because not everyone understand and like this model.
All right.
Yes. The blue color car, mm-hmm, is called the MK2.
This is the MK2.
So, so-called Mark 2 lah. Okay.
Right. So as we can see, Mark, yes, 2, the difference is the headlight.
The headlight, right? Yes. And so, the bumper.
Actually, what is the most different in between these two cars?
The engine.
Engine?
Yes.
Okay, tell us about it.
Okay, but there's one interesting part lah. Okay. For the MK1, mm-hmm, right? For the MK1, mm-hmm, the horsepower on the factory is 225 horsepower.
Okay.
Okay. But this blue MK2, mm-hmm, the factory horsepower is only 200.
How come it drop?
Yes.
Again, this is how many?
225. 225.
225 and yeah, this is 200.
Yes. Okay, it's because...
Okay, I know why. Because the economy is not good.
Okay.
So horsepower have to cut.
You are right.
Really?
Yes. Yes.
Serious?
Yes. Yes. One.
Serious?
Yes. One of the reason lah.
Okay. Serious?
Yes.
I thought I'm joking. You know, economy affect the horsepower. This is, I don't know what to say, man. Okay.
One of the small reason lah.
To us, this is only 200 horsepower.
Yes.
And the Mark 1 is already 225, but this is Mark 2. How come they drop 25 horsepower?
Okay, it's because of the emission issue.
Oh, really?
Yes, so on the newer models, mm-hmm, they have changed the engine to a newer engine.
Alright.
But for the 225, okay, is they have only one engine.
Okay.
One spec. So they have 1225 horsepower only. Okay? Okay? But for the MK2, okay, this is the base model, is 200 horsepower. But if TTS is around 280 horsepower.
Oh, TTS
on the stock. Yes.
All right. Yes. The TTS is different.
Yes, it's different. Only the turbo different.
Okay.
And the drive train.
Okay.
Okay. 280 horsepower on the stock. Okay. It's because it has a larger turbo. It's called a KO4. Okay. On the base model, they use KO3.
Oh, okay.
So on the higher end models of the TTS, is they uses the KO4 turbo.
Oh, right.
Okay. On the stock.
The means will be the Mark 2 more easier to mode to get more horsepower.
Yes. Okay. For this model, okay, we say the base model, okay. If we do ECU remap, stage 2, it can get to 260 and 270 horsepower.
Very easy.
Yes, very easy. With just an intake and downpipe mod and the ECU mod.
Alright.
Yes, okay, yes, yes. For this model, we have three models lah, okay.
But even this one got three models.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, one is a two-wheel drive version.
Okay.
Where one is the TTS line, mm, which is only front-wheel drive, okay, and one is TTS, which is quattro.
Quattro.
Okay, okay. For this MK1, okay, is quattro. Only quattro.
Only quattro.
Yes, but this we have two-wheel drive, front-wheel drive lah, and quattro. Two types.
So it's a quattro, it's a four-wheel drive.
Yes.
So
Haldex all-wheel drive.
Okay. Guys, for people who usually go for JDM, they usually will say four-wheel drive. So for Audi, they will call it quattro. When they say quattro, means it's four-wheel drive.
All-wheel drive.
All-wheel drive.
Yes, all-wheel drive. Caltex all-wheel drive. Yes.
Which is also same as Japanese four-wheel drive.
Yes. Yes.
All right. Right.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
How about the Mark III?
Okay.
Tell us the Mark III.
Okay. The Mark III. Okay. The Mark III. They have. We have three models. Okay. Same. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
This is the base model. So we have one TTS.
All right.
And one TTRS. All right. Okay. This is the base model. Okay. For the base model, they uses the EA888 Gen 3 engine.
Okay.
Okay. The turbo they uses is the IS20.
Okay.
Okay. They have around 230 or 240 horsepower. Okay. On the base model only. Okay. So if we do the same, we mod the intake, we mod the downpipe. Okay. And we do the ECU remap, it can get to, I think, 280-290 horsepower. Yeah, right. On the stage 2. Okay?
Easy to
yes.
Get horsepower, right?
Yes, you are right. So, if MK3 TTS, okay, the higher model, TTS, on the stock, the horsepower is around 300. Okay, around 300, okay? So, if they do stage 2, it's nearly, I think, 360 and 370 horsepower.
Alright.
Yeah, it's okay. Quite high. Yes, it's easier to mod lah.
Easier to mod lah.
Yes, yes, the engine is more, is stronger.
Since we talk about the stock Audi Mark 1, 2, 3, now we are more interested on the mode 1.
Yes,
can you show us some mode Audi TT?
Audi TT, yes,
yeah.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go. Okay, this is the MK3 TTRS. Okay, this is the modded one. Okay, the owner, he focused on the appearance. Okay, he focused on the appearance.
Okay,
for the engine, he only do stage 1 revamp.
Cakap saja stage 1 ya. Say only stage 1, but how many horsepower on stage 1 for this one?
Around 420.
The stage 1 already 400. He
yes.
Somehow he say not focus on horsepower.
Yes.
But not focus already 400, you know.
Yes. Stock is around 360.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, 360. Okay. Yes.
Oh, that means he only increased 40.
60. Around 60 lah.
Alright.
Okay.
So
for stage 1 only.
What the owner focus for this build actually?
Okay. The owner, he purchased a new set of the body kit.
Okay.
Okay. It's called the Yaofe Carbon Body Kit.
Okay.
Okay. It's quite rare in Malaysia. This is called the DRC Forge rim.
Okay.
This is one of the famous rims on Malaysia.
Okay.
Okay. They focus on the forge rim is because they're very lightweight.
Okay. And we can see the caliper is very big.
Stock lah.
This is stock.
This is factory ah.
Oh really ah?
You know how many port?
How many port is it?
8 port.
Crazy man.
Crazy man.
Look at the
yes.
Roto man.
Yes.
At least 360
around
there, yeah?
Yes.
Crazy. This how many inch at this ring?
19 inch. Owner ordered for 20 inch.
Okay.
but the seller mistake.
Oh.
So they give him the 19 instead of 20.
But okay lah, because when you got a thicker tire, it's more comfort.
Yeah, you are right. You are right.
How about the, you can see the side step is a carbon.
Yes, carbon. It's called the Yaofe lah. Okay.
This is the
yes.
This is the set you are talking about lah.
Yes, you are right. You are right.
So basically, this one is a bolt on this part only, or the whole bumper, or how? Actually?
Or bolt on only.
Bolt on only.
Bolt on only. Yes.
The step lah.
Yes. The diffuser.
The
yes.
Diffuser lah.
Yes.
And how about the GT wing? We can see. This is something very different because
yes, aerodynamic.
Yeah, man.
Yes. Yes.
This is something we see very
yeah.
Very nice.
Yes, yes.
Okay, is this GT ring come with the output set?
Yes.
It's complete set.
Complete set.
All right.
Yes. Basically, this carbon kit is plug and play. Okay.
Or bolt on kit.
Yes, bolt on kit. Yes.
Okay.
Okay. If one day you want to remove. It's very easy to remove.
Alright.
Okay. Install is also very easy.
Okay.
Yes. Okay, next. This is the more heavy modded one.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, we can see this
yes.
Is a more garang type, more
yes.
Type. Huh?
Yes.
Okay. Tell us about it because we already excited to see this car.
Okay. This car, okay, on the ECU, the engine ECU is stage 2.
Alright.
Okay, by TVS Engineering.
Okay.
Okay. On the TCU, TCU stands for the transmission control unit, okay? for the TCU map, the DSG map lah, okay? It's also TVS Stage 3.
Oh.
Yes.
So this car, about how much the output?
Around 500 wheel horsepower.
Crazy.
Yes.
This car is 500
wheel horsepower.
500 on wheels, man. It's yes. not on engine, yeah. Yes. It's 500 on wheels.
Around 600 on engine lah.
Serious.
Estimate lah.
Oh my.
Around lah.
All right. Okay. Okay.
Yes. This yes.
But compare this body kit and that body kit.
Yes.
You find out that body kit is more fierce.
Yes.
And this is also fierce, but a bit simple. You can see everything is
yes.
more small piece.
Yes.
So is this guy not so into outlook, or he just more focused on performance?
He focused on the both.
Both?
Yes, both. Because they have their own taste, okay? A lot of DT, they want something similar like this.
Okay.
Yes,
okay.
Yes,
so
yes.
you want something different.
Yes, something different.
That means that it's more popular and more people go for that look.
Yes.
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 Actually, I like that, man.
Okay.
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 Alright?
Okay. Yes.
Check out the wheels. This is crazy. What wheel is this?
Okay, this is the Rotorex design. This is a 20-inch. Okay.
Okay.
Fully customized.
So this is customized wheels?
Yes. It's also forged wheels.
Is it, you mean customized is one and only in the world?
Yes.
Serious?
Yes, you are right.
One and only in the world?
Yes.
Oh my goodness, this
okay.
is damn cool, man.
Yes.
The design, you can check out the design, man.
Yes.
Alright.
Okay.
So this is, what's the size?
This is a 20 inch.
20 inch?
Yes, 20 inch.
Check out the tire, it's so low profile
okay.
compared to the previous one.
But TTRS comes in 20 inch on the stock.
Serious?
Yes, on the
so
factory.
This car original, they come with 20 inch.
20 inch, yes.
That means that one, he actually downgrade from 20 to 19.
Yes, because the seller mistaken.
Wrong, okay,
yes, yes, right, yes, yes, right. yes.
How about the braking system?
Okay, the owner have upgraded the braking system
okay.
from the original TTRS 8 port right. to this Brembo 6 right. port.
And check out the roto. This is very unique roto. Eh?
Yes, 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 yes.
It's not round.
Yes.
Okay, and this is a two-piece floating disc.
Yes.
Alright.
Yes, this is called the Audi RS rotor.
This is a crazy mode. But do you have anything more crazy than this one?
Yes. Yes.
Alright.
Okay.
So this is the person in charge.
Hello, hello, yes. hello, hello.
Okay. This is Gary.
Gary.
Okay, from Quarter Zone.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, it's one of the boss here lah. Okay, okay.
Consider
yes.
founder, not
okay.
boss. not really boss lah.
Yeah, okay.
I like when they say boss. When I meet boss, I'm very happy because we are going to ask for a sponsor.
Oh my god. Today you can saw the sponsor.
So, oh yeah. Alright.
Okay,
thank you to them because
the main sponsors lah.
Yeah, today actually as we say, we're looking for sponsor. And they are one of the sponsors for the event. Thank you very much.
So thanks for the organizer for giving chance.
Alright. Hey Gary.
Yeah.
Tell us, this is the monster?
Yeah, exactly, it's the monster, bro. So okay. this one is actually the 2017 Audi TT RS.
Okay.
Okay, with 2.5 liter engine.
Okay.
And then the original horsepower will be 400.
Wow.
Okay, so you can see the outlook is slightly different with the other original TT RS.
Yes.
Okay. So you can see the canard. Okay, so the side canard.
But all this is a bolt-on or is original actually?
Okay, that's why it's the bolt-on. But
okay.
we bought the original Audi TTRS performance pack.
Oh, okay.
Which from the original Audi with whole kit, the side skirt, and then with the rear diffuser
okay.
and the spoiler.
So this is like a DTM spoiler.
Yeah,
it's
exactly.
DTM look.
Yes. So I think so far in Malaysia only one set. Only one set, the original one. Only one set.
Serious?
Yeah.
This, okay, so this set, the original, as we can see, is fully carbon
yes.
fiber.
It's a fully dry carbon fiber.
Dry
carbon fiber.
Guys, carbon, make sure, it's dry carbon and carbon is totally two different things. Dry carbon means original performance parts. Very lightweight. Carbon wrapping oil itu semua untuk tambah berat for on weight. So make sure it's different things, right?
Okay.
So,
sorry. This is the Miltech from England.
Okay.
So it's the track spec.
It's a track spec.
Yes, it's a track spec.
So since we talk about exhaust, can you show us the engine a bit?
Of course.
Right.
Yeah, let's go.
Wow, damn. This is so colorful, man.
Yeah.
So it's original yellow, this car?
Yeah, this car is actually original yellow, and then the gray color is the red.
Oh, the gray is the red.
Yep.
this is a wrap actually.
Yeah, exactly.
I thought it's a pin.
Yeah, because the finishing is quite good. So when you look at it, you just feel like the pin.
Okay, okay. This so, engine looks very, very packed. Very, very compact. Tell us about the performance of
it. Okay, so now this car is actually having the Revo Stage 2 ECU tune.
Okay.
Okay, and then the intake, we're using the Venturi Stage 3 intake.
Okay.
Okay, actually you can see inside here, got the intercooler upgraded.
Yeah, okay. this is huge, man.
Yes, some more using the black color, so it's quite low profile.
Ah,
so
why Audi people so low profile?
Yeah, because just don't let people see too much power inside.
Okay, alright, cool, alright. And we see this is full dry carbon.
Yes.
And we know, once this look we see like this, we know this is not cheap. I just want to know this set is
okay,
how much?
So it's estimate this set with the turbo inlet you can see here.
Alright,
so it's about 14k.
14k?
Yeah, 14k whole set.
This one intake only is 14k, guys. No joke, man. What is the output for this engine?
Actually, now on engine is about 580. 580.
580, that's
yep.
A lot.
Yeah, that's a lot.
Right, and yeah. We can see the suspension.
Yes. This is a Nitron absorber actually.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a Nitron 3-way because this car is used to be clocked the fastest Audi in Sepang.
Really?
So clocked 219. 2:19 seconds.
219 the
yes,
timing.
Yes, yes, with great. With the RE71 RS tire.
It's a performance tire. Only.
Yes, performance and not semi slick.
Not semi slick.
Yes, exactly.
All right, good. So this is something very cool. Tell us about the rim.
Yes. Ah, guys, this rim. So just fixed for the purpose, fixed for the auto show today.
See,
so yes.
This is a race engineering, guys.
Yes, race.
So guys, not only JDM using race, yeah. Now European are mixing around with JDM wheels. This is how it looks more cool than you are using the European everything European things.
Yeah.
Why go for race engineering for this Audi?
Yeah, the first thing is because of the lightweight. So we chose the race because always the weight is good for the race and also good for the street use. Okay, and then the next is the design. So you can see, look around here, actually not much Japanese rim inside the Audi. So it will be look special. Some more will be look more sporty actually. More on motorsport style.
How about your caliper? You are running AP.
Yes, yes, AP racing.
People are going for Brembo.
Yeah, this one actually because we are going to track.
Going for track?
Yeah.
So still believe in AP, yeah?
Yeah.
So this is what we have today for the Audi TT gathering. So this one really make me, I want to have a test drive one day with the Audi.
Yeah, sure. Got chance.
The Audi guy. Sorry ya, Bekin, saya ambil you punya kawan sekejap lah. Sekarang saya pun nak buat video untuk Audi pula ya, Bekin. Can lah. So okay guys, so until here, if you guys like Audi, remember catch up with this group and then you can learn more from this group, right?
Yes.
Can you tell us a bit about the sponsor? What
okay.
Do you have today?
Okay, we have Liquimoli.
Alright.
Okay, the lubricant. Okay.
Okay.
We have Amitrix, the exhaust.
Alright.
Amitrix with secret flow lah.
Okay.
Secret flow, okay. For the exhaust. Mm. And we have Quattro Zone.
Alright.
Okay. Okay. And we have the Rep 63 lah. Okay, it's the Rep shop lah.
It's a Rep shop.
Yes.
Alright.
Okay.
Okay.
And we have the Genius Carbon.
Okay.
They specialize on carbon. Please search us on Facebook. Search for Audi TT Sports Club Malaysia. Okay, for the Instagram, same name.
So guys, remember if you like Audi, remember search for their group. This is the Audi TT Club Malaysia. For those who are from overseas, also welcome to contact with them. Might be some collaboration in the future with them as well. So until the next video, we see you again. This is today is a TT SCM annual gathering. This is a 4th year and today they have about 70 Audi TT here, right? We can't show you all the video for this gathering, but if you want to see the photo, remember check out our Facebook Kazuto Garage Facebook page. We have all the attending car for the photo in the album. All right, so until next video, we see you again. Bye.